Sometimes when you run across these Mossberg 22s, the price is so low, you just can't say no. Let's check it out. Here we are today with the Mossberg Model 352KB. This is a 22 semi-automatic 18 and a half inch barrel. This is capable of firing short, high velocity, long or long rifle rounds. Now this one, you know, I have quite a collection of these Mossbergs if you're familiar with the channel. Today we're going to go a little bit short form. I'm not going to go back over a lot of the stuff we've covered with the others. You know how one runs into another with these things, you know what I mean? Especially with these Mossbergs. They're an amazing company that they came out with so many different little idiosyncrasies with these 22s, like all basically built on the same chassis, you know, which was always very interesting to me. So the 352 series here might seem familiar to you because we did do the Mossberg. You could check back. I have these videos up there posted. The 342 KA. Okay, here that one is right here. These are definitely like brother and sister. Obviously, bolt action here. This is the bolt action semi-automatic action of the same rifle. So there's a couple of things here that you could use to kind of date them, but you can never really narrow it down. Both of these 1961 to 1966. And how you can narrow it down is just by kind of how they're set up. This round grip here on the 352 is kind of like the older style. Well, it is the older style, and the squared off pistol grip here is more the newer style. So this would be closer to the 66 side. This guy would be closer to the 61 side. And you know, there's a couple of other little things that sight variations and things like that, different variations in the sight. So you could break it down here. I was just going to leave it at that, but I'll pull this up again. Wanted to go a little short form with these from now on. These the Remington Model 58 video right before this. I took a lot of criticism for it being a, what was it, like an hour and a half long video, then three installments after that of half hour each or so. And I guess people just don't have that much time to listen to me, so. Kind of thought I'm filling up somebody's, like, a couple of hours of the day where they got to sit and chill and just watch something, but apparently not. So we're going to try to stick a couple of these. I got like some loose ends to tie up. Like, this guy is just a loose end. It's a model that I didn't even really think I'd do a video on because it's so close to some of the others. There's also the, if you check it out, the New Haven, I think it's 250 CA. Is that what it is? Yes. The 250 CA is a New Haven, which is the, the, what do they call it, the like the department store brand of Mossberg. And I have one of this gun. The only difference with that one is it has a couple of things that are different. It doesn't have the finger grooves here, and it doesn't have, on both of these, have these fold down, these things that have, like, for when you lay prone, you could use it as a I forget what they call that. You could use that as a monopod. So the 250 CA, the New Haven one, doesn't have that, but it's basically the same gun. So it's just one of those things where I was like, Maybe it doesn't need to be covered, but the interesting thing here is to pull up, oh, here it is again, I'm sorry, here, this list right here. So this list right here, you could see, look under 342 here first. So with 342, these start in 1957. These are the same as the Model 340, which 340 was the full length barrel and no full down forend. So the 342 is the carbine with the full down forend target sights. 58 to 60, these had open sights. It shows which sights they use. The S134, which those are not the ones that are on this one. The KA for 61 to 66 has an improved firing pin. And then the change in magazines, we'll get to that. That was in 67 with the KB. This one, 352 KB, the changes through the years are a little bit different. This is the fold down, this is the carbine fold down forend version of the 350, right? Am I right here? Fold down forend. The 350, yes, it was box fed. So you have to watch, you have to be careful. Sometimes you cross-reference these numbers and you don't even realize, you're like, oh yeah, that's the same as this one, but the tube fed, box fed are all mixed in, the numbers are all mixed together, so that's why it gets a little bit confusing, so I apologize. But 352 was the semi-auto box fed fold down forend. The 352K is the economy open sights. 352KA with the dovetail rear sight. And then here is, so the KB, it's all just sight differences. So the 352KB here is just, it's the same as the 352KA, except it has an S138 and an S141 rear sight. The S141 rear sight looks like this, where it's adjustable. It has that little adjustable insert inside. And it was the 352KC in 67 that went to the new firing pin. So this one apparently would have the old firing pin. It'd be kind of interesting to compare the two. But I think the only difference is that the front of the firing pin on the 342, that improved firing pin, is just a trapezoidal type shape to the end of the firing pin, I think was the only difference. And the magazine change that they're talking about, both of these have a very interesting magazine. And I'm telling you, what I paid for the gun, I could buy, what you would pay for one of these magazines, I could buy probably eight of these rifles. Honestly, these magazines alone, they're about $100 now. I mean, they're insane. But these are the 1220 mag, which both of these take. And they are adjustable for short, long, and long rifle. And how they do that is they have this tab here that this is set for long rifle. And then you could move this back to here for long. And then you could move this back again for shorts. So it has this floating adjuster here and this cutout in the follower to be able to do that. And these mags, these adjustable ones, they did replace them finally. Like after a few years, they got rid of these. Now, I don't know if it was a cost saving feature, but they just didn't work so well. These broke very easy. So a lot of times you get excited. I've been in gun stores where I've seen these and I see this mag. And I pull it out and I see that it's one of these adjustable ones. And then this piece is missing. So without this piece, obviously, it's not going to work. You know, if these break really easy, if you get a round jammed in there and you really beat the action, you beat the bolt up trying to cycle, you know, 22s are. And if it got stuck against this thing, you know, and it's in this position, let's say with a short even, or you can imagine that you could just bust that right off. I'm lucky to have two of them that are in a decent shape, but it's one of the reasons why when I saw this that I just had to grab it. This scope right here comes with it, a Bushnell Sport View. How could you say no? I think I'm gonna take it off though. I kind of like the open sights on it, but had to take a serious cleaning. It really was a disaster. And the shooting it, it's a little sticky. I gotta see what's going on. It's something, something's a little weird with it. I was able to run through a couple of mags, and then there was it seemed like the round in the magazine was interfering with the feeding of the one that it was picking up. There's a little bit of a binding issue going on over there, and it just might be that it's just not happy. Number one, it could be that that is one of the issues with these mags. I don't really have that many problems with them before, but a different mag that didn't have this adjuster kind of acted the same way. So I'm thinking that it just maybe needs a little bit of an adjustment. But it would run through a couple of mags here and there. It was working okay. Here's some action of it, actually firing. Didn't really spend a tremendous time at the range. And again, don't let me forget, we're going short form here. So let me take a look here, see what we got as far as some information on this I could throw down that maybe I missed. And then we're out. So let's see. The folding fore end, that fold end, folding, it's called a tenite folding extension grip. Those are made out of wood from 48 to 55. Then they turn to plastic. It is a synthetic molded fore end that folds down for hand grip or prone monopod. That's how Mossberg marketed them. They have side sling swivels. Both of these did actually. We'll turn them around the other way. Both of these come equipped with sling swivels, which is kind of cool. They were on the side here. One up here, one back here. And they did come with a sling, I believe, originally. But it's really, what's one of the weird things is that you never see that sling on these. I've seen a couple of pictures of them and they look awful cardboardy. So I'm thinking the reason why you never see them is because they just literally didn't survive. Literally. They look that kind of that crappy. Again, both of these should have the number 1220 adjustable mag. They were both manufactured before the changeover to the just fixed long rifle mag. And yeah, it's basically just a semi-auto version of the 342. So that is the story, ladies and gentlemen. Took to a nice cleaning. I really was surprised that it was porpoising like that. But I did it was I call it porpoising because it kind of was like the tip of the round was kind of getting stuck on its way into the chamber. These are kind of their newer design Mossberg. And to be honest with you, I always had better luck with the older designs. But I did do a little tweaking in here, and it needs another trip back to the range just to check it out. But the wood on these is really nice. It's like real walnut. It's not that plasticky crap. This is real walnut, And this one, there was like a little chip up here that looks like somebody repaired. Every once in a while, you see some cracks in the stocks on these. People tighten these down too hard, but this one, luckily, none of that crazy cracking and the finger groove thing here wasn't peeling away from the wood like they do so much. Actually, both of these were nice like that. Every once in a while, you see that those things shrink for some reason. Some of them shrink, some of them don't. You kind of wonder what storage method caused the shrinking. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, under 15 minutes to bring you the 352 KB. And again, if you want to explore past Milsurp garage, I could link them all down below, but Just do a search on the channel. Somehow you got to be able to do that. We got the 142K, the 144 LSA, the 151K, the 250 CA, the 320B, the 342 KA, the 346 BA, this one, of course, the 352 KB, and in 22 Magnum, we have the 340T. That is an awesome one. Check that guy out. That one and the 144 LSA are must-watch videos. Oh, those are two awesome ones. And so that's it. Another Mossberg in the stable, ladies and gentlemen. We love, up. See, 16 minutes now. See, I can't stop. I just can't stop. So yeah, we're going to go short form on the 4th of July. And got another couple of loose ends I wanted to tie up on some examples that I really didn't think I was going to do videos on, but it just gives me an opportunity to get in, say a little something, say hello, and get out. Before an hour and a half goes by. Thanks for tuning in. Going back into Mossberg land. I got some more research to do on these guys myself. And enjoy your 4th of July.